Rosetta Thorpe was big in my life at that point.
My sister played most really good rock and roll blues guitar.
Ripping into gospel songs. And she played electric guitar and had a Hammond B3 and a drummer, you know, as a part of church music, which was like, whoa.
Worked and bought it. I'd go from door to door and ask people, did it need someone to work for them? Sometimes they would just look at me, sometimes they'd shut the door. No, we don't need nobody. And I went to one lady's house, and when she opened the door, she said, after I got through telling her what I could do, she said, what could a little girl like you do? I said, Miss, I can help you with your vegetables, I can set your table, I can sweep your kitchen. I can help with the children, I can bring in your wood, and I can make your fire. I had all of that on one string. So she says, well, come in. Then she opened the door and I went in. Then she hired me that day. And I started working for her. She paid me 75 cents a month. Then after I worked a while, I guess she could see that I could do exactly what I said I could do. But she says to me, we're going to pay you more money. She said, we're going to give you 25 cents more, which made me get $1 a month. I gave the money to my mother and asked her to buy me a guitar. My mother bought the guitar and paid $3.75 for it. Then after Mama bought the guitar, it was to her sorrow because she didn't get no more rest. Then I started banging on that, trying to learn how to play the guitar because I didn't know what to do with all those strings.
In the late 30s, a new style of diva was emerging, the girl singers. During this era of swing and big bands, almost every orchestra had a female vocalist like Ivy Anderson, Hannah Sylvester, Mabel Smith, Helen Humes, and the great Lena Horne.
Anymore. Those were some mean women, boy. They can get low enough to crawl on the snake.
Jitterbug, born in the black community, swept the dance halls across the country. The rapid two-step footwork, intermittent hand contact, and spectacular acrobatics were all the rage. Even though the economy remained stagnant, Americans still found ways to get their kicks. By 1939, the swing era was full tilt as audiences across the nation went wild. It was Benny Goodman, dubbed the King of Swing, who introduced this new music. It was also Benny Goodman who first integrated black musicians, including Lionel Hampton and Teddy Wilson, into his band. Now, at the height of her popularity, Ethel Waters was the newest rising star on stage and screen. She was a sensation. Ethel Waters emerged as the first diva to deal with racial issues through popular songs.
When you sang your love song, you used to make me sigh. I knew. When you called me, I followed and followed you till I was swallowed by quicksand. It was the devil who brought you to me. Now I'm caught in those quicksands that keep dragging me down. Quicksand. I know your love couldn't last. Here am I, sinking fast in those quicksands that keep on dragging me down. It was a deadly street. I was walking with you from the start. How can I be ever carry my home? I heard those beautiful lies with my eyes for disguise, then those quicksands started pulling me down, down, way down.
In 1939, the great opera singer Marian Anderson was barred from Washington's Constitution Hall by the Daughters of the American Revolution because she was black. In protest, she sang at the Lincoln Memorial on a chilly Easter Sunday before a large, unsegregated audience arranged by Eleanor Roosevelt. Forward 40s brought us jazz pianist Hazel Scott, who made her way to the top with her pounding boogie-woogie rhythms, and Sugar Childs Robinson, the seven-year-old sensation. The 40s brought us the great Billie Holiday. Surrounding herself with great musicians like Jerry Mulligan, Lester Young, and Ben Webster, Lady Day represented for Black America the modern woman who had made it into the system without losing her roots.
Thank you.
with all her success, her traumatic past began to creep back. Personal and professional deterioration set in quickly and plummeted Billy to the depths of despair. Despite her problems, she opened the doors to the chic supper clubs, paving the way for other female black artists like Ella Fitzgerald, the queen of Harlem's Savoy Ballroom. Ella had her own band, proving that women could operate in a man's world. In the music world, Memphis country boy Elvis Aaron Presley launched his career with blues favorites That's All Right Mama, originally recorded by Arthur Big Boy Crudup, and Hound Dog by the immortal Big Mama Thornton. By the time Elvis was called up for duty in the army and sent to Germany, his popularity was worldwide.
When I came up here, I was like 21 years old. I was living down in Memphis. I had a job down there working on the farm, picking cotton, chopping cotton. And I was tired of picking cotton, so I said, I'm going to Chicago. They tell me if you go up there, you can find a real good job.
That game you play, make you want to
went to see Howlin' Wolf because there he was one of my favorite people. And the Howlin' Wolf got up and made the announcement. He said, we got little Coco in the house. We gonna see can we get her up here to do a couple of tunes for us. So sure enough, when he got through with his, what he was gonna do, now he wanted to go get him a little nip. So he goes and called me up and go to the back so he could get that bottle.
Two strikes, you know.
I got up there and I did two songs. When I came down, I met this big man, all tall, rad back and everything. He goes, I'm Willie Dixon. Girl, I like the way you sing them blues. He said, I'd like to take you down to Chess. Next day, Leonard Chess, he listened to my voice and he said, yeah, she got the voice now. Says, I want you to start working on her right away. Dixon came back with the tune that I'm working on tonight. That was the first tune on Chess record, was I Got What It Takes.
Yeah, I got what it takes. Make a good man in my name.
Think blues music is something to make you look sad, look down at yourself. But I tell everybody, not my blues. My music is like a therapy. It's designed to make people look up, pep up, get up, smile, feel better about themselves.
Yeah!